Hello, through this video we will show you how you can redesign your existing power line. Before we import our power line, you have to know that your format of your imported power line should be in CSV or TXT format. So it does mean that this record with both types like tension or suspension and with XYZ coordinates has to be in CSV or TXT format, like these two. So if you want to import your power line, you should go here on import power line, then you can set the name of your power line, you can set station, and you can set support name. I would say, for example, like this one. Then you can set the tension support model, suspension support model, and you can set your weather and reference conditions. And at the end, you can import your file. Go here and choose your file. As I said, it could be in TXT or CSV extension. Okay, as you can see, we have our power line, existing power line. Now you can, for example, add supports or remove supports like this. I will go in 3D view. And for example, if you want to remove reports, choose report, select and remove. You can also remove suspension or tension supports. Okay. Of course, you can add your support. You can choose, do you want suspension to add or tension, and what kind of model you want to add. Okay. As you can see here, this support is on zero high, or okay, or Z coordinates is zero. So you have to go here on edit support and set your Z coordinate, for example, like this. Press OK, and as you can see, your support now has Z coordinates. Okay, you can also add your insulator. You go here on add insulator and choose your support. Then you can choose your attachment point. And then here in opening dialog, you can set your type, you can set your insulator model, and you can apply it to all supports from the say data model. Okay. And as you can see, you add your insulator, but the quicker way is to go here on add insulator. And if you want to add insulators to all attachment points, you can choose these options to apply to all supports of the same data model. In this, you can see that this is tension support. Now we have to add our insulators to suspension support. By that I mean I will add to my all suspension supports. So you have to click here on apply to all supports and just press OK. And as you can see, we have added insulators to all suspensions and tensions supports. Now we have to add conductors and ground wire. We have to choose your power line, then in the opening dialog you can set the name of your conductor, you can set the model. You can set from which support you want to add your conductor, on which attachment point you want to add, and you can set your weather and reference conditions. Okay. And now I will add my ground wire. Just click on your power line and you can set the name of your ground wire, the model, You can set from which to which support you want to add. You can set, of course, your weather and referent conditions. And now, as you can see, this is our power line in 3D view or our power line in 2D view.